God that he might rent up in the momentary hope the Lamb that towered on the Lord came to charm my to recall the summer's alarm of demand to the and to all Israel into the not go at war, fight against your brethren, return every man to his house, for his sin is done of me, and they obeyed the words of the Lord, and returned from the Jeroboam and Rehoboam dwelt in Jerusalem and built cities for defense in Judah. He built it in Bethlehem and Tekoah and Bissah and Shoko and Adullam and Beth and Maresha and Zifad and Oreim and Lachish and Zorah and Aijalon and Hebron, which are in Judah and in Benjamin, fenced cities and he fortified the strongholds and put captives in them, and tore a Sheshual and a Shoil and wine and in every shields and spears and made them exceed this strong chest in Judah and Benjamin on his side and the priests and the Levites that were in all Israel resorted to him out of all their coasts, for the Levites left their suburbs and their possession and came to Judah and Jerusalem. Jeroboam and his sons God's handcast memo from
Twice we
sisters, turn all head children through. Out of the prison to the adventure of the safety and evasion. Lift you a little above. Nods and he desired. Many voices in set. Turn from it. Shattered when the bit came to the swim, retold the one that is established the kingdom and the strength of chains and fee for souls. And all is real with him, and it came to pass that in the fifth year of the recall, no one played the timony, God came above and stood. Jerusalem be taught. They had transgressed against the Lord which dwells on. Drop chariots and trees tore. Thousand horsemen and the numbers that came with shame out of Egypt. So you mixed us Europeans and the Ethiopians, and he took the fenced cities which attained to Judah and came to Jerusalem's head, came to my prophet to retold the one and to the princes of Judah that were mastered to better to Jerusalem be to such I shepherds said unto them, thus saith the Lord, ye have forsaken me, and therefore shall I also left you in the hand of thy chat where upon the prince of Israel and the king humbled themselves and praised the Lord is righteous. And when the Lord saw that they humbled themselves, the word of the Lord came to the light. Therefore I will not destroy them, but I will grant them some deliverance, and my wrath shall not be poured out upon Jerusalem by God. And I shall measure the lest they shall be his servant, that they may know my service and the service of the kingdoms of God. Three so I shall give the kingdom of God and Jerusalem and put away the treasures of the house of the Lord, and the treasures of God, his house. He took all, he carried away also God. He was on gold which Solomon had made instead, on which every home of a maid she was a present, committed then to the heads of the chief of the entrance of the king's house. And when the king entered into the house of the Lord, the guard came and fetched them and brought them again into the guard chamber. And when he humbled himself, the wrath of the Lord turned from him, that he would not destroy him altogether and all. So into the things went well. So King Rehoboam strengthened himself in Jerusalem, and reigned for Rehoboam was 140 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 17 years in Jerusalem, the city which the Lord had chosen out of all the tribes of Israel to put his name there. And his mother's name was Naaman, an Ammonite, and he did evil because he prepared not his heart to seek the Lord. Now the acts of Rehoboam first and blessed are they not written in the book of Shemaiah the prophet? And David, though the seer concerned, will be me all of peace. And there were wars between Rehoboam and Jeroboam continually, and Rehoboam slept with his fathers, and was buried in the city of David. And Abijah his son reigned in his tents in Bethlehem. Chronicles chapter 13, now in the 18th year of King Jeroboam began Abijah to reign over Judah. He reigned 3 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name also was Maaseiah. And there was war between Abijah and Jeroboam. And Abijah said to that to liberate with an army of the young men of war, even 400,000 chosen men. Jeroboam also said to that to liberate against him with 800,000 chosen men, being mighty men of valor. And they might just hold up upon mountain Moreh, which is in Mount Ephraim, and said, "Hear me, O Jeroboam, and all Israel, ought ye not to know that the Lord God of Israel gave the kingdom over Israel to David forever, even to him and to his sons by a covenant of salt? Yet Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, the servant of Solomon, the son of David, is risen up and hath rebelled against his Lord, and there are baptized unto him made men of children of me. And strength of hands and tongue and street, although of the son of Solomon. When Rehoboam was young and tender-hearted and could not withstand them, and now he to withstand the kingdom of the Lord in the hand of the sons of David, and he be a great multitude, and there are with you both the camps which Jeroboam made you. For gods have ye not cast out the priests of the Lord, the sons of Aaron and the Levites, and have made you priests after the manner of the nations of the earth, and so have whosoever cometh to tongues of great chins and with a young bullock and set the ranks, the same may be a priest of them that are no gods. But as for us, the Lord is our God, and we have not forsaken him, and the priests which minister unto the Lord are the sons of Aaron, and the Levites wait upon their business, and pay them unto the Lord every
sacrifice us, and sweet incense, the true bread also set, say in order. Untap your table, and the candlestick handled with the lamps thereunto the manner. Evening for we keep the heart of the Lord our God, that he had forsaken him, and behold, God himself is with us for our captain, and his priests with sounding trumpets to cry alarm against you, O children of Israel, fight ye not against the Lord, God of your fathers, for ye cannot prosper, but terrible unpass them, and but meant to come about behind them, so they will be for to the end be. And ambushment was behind them, and when to the Lord that beheld the battle was before and behind, and they cried unto Lord, and the priest sound that with the trumpet sent the men unto the veil about, and then the men unto the fount of it came to smoke Jeroboam and all Israel before Abijah and Judah and the children of Israel fled before his people slew them with a great slaughter, so their phantoms lay but Israel 500,000 chosen men. Children of Israel were brought under at that time, and the children of Judah remained before they relied upon the with the towns thereon, and Bethnoth with the towns thereon. servants, 60 daughters, and the rest of the and his ways and his sayings are written in the story of the prophet in the
their targets.
and steers out unto the 300,000 and out of men come out at their heels, and through those 204,000 bones, these were mighty men, but there were, and there came out against them
read away.
cheated. And those in abundance and returned to Jerusalem's invincible and from it chapter 15 ends up. Spirit of God came up on a Syriaca, son of Obed, and he went out to meet us and said unto him, hear ye me, Asa, and all Judah, and then come unto the Lord is with you, while ye be with him, and if ye and he will be found. Are you not if ye forsake him, he will forsake you now for a long season. Israel has been with the true God, and without a teaching priest, and without law, but when they in their trouble did turn unto the Lord God of Israel, and such in he was found of them, and in those times there was no gift to him that went out, nor to him that came. In that great next day, sons were in hand the tongue, the countries and nation was destroyed, a nation and city, a city for God did bless them with all adversity. Be ye strong therefore, and let not your hands be weak, for your work shall be rewarded. And when Asa heard these words, and the prophecy alone, then the prophecy took courage, and put away the abama, mama light of salvation, the land of Judah, and men come on and out and pass it. These which he had taken from Mount be freedom and remove the altar. But the Lord that was before the Lord was the Lord, and he that stood all to the end, Benjamin and the strangers, with them out of his freedom, and Manasseh and Simeon, for they fell to him out of Israel in abundance, when they saw that the Lord his God was with him, so they that the transcends to Bethel at Jerusalem in the third month, in the 15th year of the reign of Asa, and they offered unto the Lord the same time of the spoil which they had brought them, none from blood, but some eggs and none. 1,000 sheep, and they entered into a path, none unto to seek the Lord God of their fathers, with all their heart and with all their soul, that whosoever would not seek the Lord God of Israel should be put to death, with the small or great, with the man or woman, and they swear unto the Lord with a loud voice, and with shouting, and with trumpets, and with cornets, and all to the rejoiced, that be sworn with all their heart, and sought with their whole desire. And he was found of them, and the Lord gave them rest round about, and also concerning May, Atata, Matavasata, and he removed her from between me, for she had made an idol in a grove, and also cut down her idol, and stamped it, and burnt it, and God broke the drum of the high places, were not taken away out of Israel. Nevertheless, the heart of Asa was perfect all his days, and he brought into the house of God the things that his father had led the gate to, and that he himself had led the gate to, silver and gold and jewels. And there was no more war unto the fight, and the 20th year of the reign of Asa, sin been set, John Chronicles chapter 16, in the 36th year of the reign of Asa, they are shut in on Israel, came up against Judah, and built Ramah to the intent that he might let none go out or come in to us again unto the Hema, the brought out silver and gold out of the precious unto the house unto the Lord and unto his house and said to them, hey, that Hema, Syria hath dwelt at Damascus, saying, there is a league between me and thee, as there was between my father and thy father. Behold, I have sent thee silver and gold, go break thy league with Baasha, king of Israel, that he may depart from me, and then take that heart unto and sent the captains of his armies against the cities of Israel, and they smote Ijon and them, and they built him and all the store cities of Naphtali. And it came to pass when they of the herd it that he left off building a rainbow and let his work cease, and was a token to hold to the and they carried the the stones of Ramah and the timber thereof wherewith Baasha was building, and he built therewith Nebo and Mizpah, and at that time Hanani the seer came to Asa, came unto God and said unto him, because thou hast relied on the king of Syria and not relied on the Lord thy God, therefore is the host of the king of Syria escaped out of thine hand, were not the Ethiopians and the Lubins of huge host with very many chariots and horsemen, yet because thou didst rely on the Lord, he delivered them into thine hand. For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth, to chieftains and strong in the behalf of men, whose heart is the faith the Lord him heareth. Thou hast done foolishly, therefore from henceforth thou shalt have wars, and also was wroth with the seer, and put him in a prison house, for he was in a rage with him, because of his sin. thus oppressed, some of the kingdoms the same time, and they hold the acts of us of first and last, lo, they are written in the book of the kings of Judah and Israel, and us are in the to be and ninth year of his reign was this. He stimmed his feet until his disease was exceeding great, yet in his disease he sought not to the Lord, but to the physicians, and the sores with which his fathers and mine in the 1 and 40th year of his reign, and they buried him in his own set of shoes which he had made for himself in the city of David, and laid him in the bed which was filled with sweet odors and divers kinds of spices, prepared by the apothecaries art, and they made a very great meal for shins in bins, and from it all scatters and on team, and the apothecaries are reigned in stead, and strengthened himself against Israel, and he placed forces in all the fenced cities of Judah, and set garrisons in the land of Judah and in the cities of Ephraim, which also his father had taken, and the Lord was with the prophet because he walked in the first ways of his father David, and sought not unto his father, and walked in his commandments, and not after the doings of Israel. Therefore the Lord established the kingdom his hand, and all Judah brought to the prophet presents, and he had riches and honor in abundance, and his heart was lifted up in the ways of the Lord. Moreover, he took away the high places and brought out unto the also in the third year of of his reign, peace and to his prince us healing to men pale and to all the fire and to
to the heart.
waters unto the repentance of thousands, and not a sheep fed with sin. Mighty men of them were 300,000, and next to him was Tahoe. Four thousand, and next him was a Messiah, the son of Zichri, who willingly offered himself unto the Lord, and with him to the drops of mighty men of Shemuel and of Benjamin, Eli and Amai, men of Shemuel, and with him armed men with bow and shield 200,000, and next him was Jehoshaphat, and with him 104,000 red beasts prepared for the war. He waved a bolt at him beside, so soon that his bolt in the fenced city threw out onto the civil's head. From it of chapter 18 of Jehoshaphat had riches and honor in abundance, and joined us in the years. He went down to Ahab to Samaria, and Ahab him sheep and oxen for him in abundance, and for the him and the slaves of him to go up with him to reign. Most men we are them, they set him on Israel's head unto Jehoshaphat, him unto the wind, shall go with me to Ramoth. Then we are them, he answered him, I am as thou art, and mighty, blessed I thee, the land we will be with thee. The war, and Jehoshaphat God said unto the pillar, Israel, lift thy eye, pray thee, at the word of the Lord to thy prayer for the pillar Israel, Bethel to Bethel, a prophet for a brother, and said unto them, shall we go to Ramoth, then we they said, go up, for God will deliver it in to cut his hand, but Jehoshaphat said, is here a prophet of the Lord besides that we might inquire of him and of him? But Israel said unto Jehoshaphat, there is yet one man by whom we may inquire the Lord, but I hate him, for he never brought the sideboard unto me, but always he the same is lifted high, the Son of Imlah, and Jehoshaphat said, let not the king say so, and the pillar is untold for the chase of forces and said fetched with we met by the Son of Imlah, and the tail of Israel, and the that him unto the set he drew of them. On his throne dwelt in there, robes and face at him a void place at the entering. Maria and all the prophets prophesied before them, and said, the child of the Son of Chinea had made him whole and said, thus saith the Lord, with peace
such emplosery. But him they begun. Soon then all the wrath. Such wrath as I so say. In the love to Belial and Thruster, for color can deliver it into the hand of the pin and the mess of the hat went to call it high stay to. Sent with thy word, therefore I pray thee be like one of theirs, and speak how good and Micaiah said, as the Lord liveth, my God saith, hath will I speak, and when he was come to the king, the king said unto him, Micaiah, shall we go to we ought to bet the Lord, shall I forbear? And he said, go ye up and thrust her, and they shall be delivered into and then the king said to him, how many times shall I adore thee, that thou say nothing but the truth to me in the name of the Lord? And he said, I did see all Israel scattered upon the mountains, as sheep that had no shepherd. And the Lord said, he said, no master let them return, therefore house in peace, and the king of Israel unsent to Jehoshaphat did. I loved and pleased that he would not prophesy good unto me, but he shall love. And he said, therefore hear the word of the Lord. I sought the Lord, sit him upon his throne, and all the host of heaven stand him on his right hand, and on his left. And the Lord said, who shall it, I say, happen of Israel, that he may go out and fall at Ramoth Gilead, and one state, saying that
his men, not a day. They left her set members, and there came out a spirit and stood before the Lord and said, I will entice him. And the Lord said unto him, wherewith? And he said, I will go out and be a light in spirit in the mouth of all his prophets. And the Lord said, thou shalt entice him, and thou shalt also prevail, go out and do even so. Now therefore, behold, the Lord hath put a lie in spirit in the mouth of these thy prophets, and the Lord hath spoken evil against thee, and said, the eye of the sun, that she may unattain there, and smoke with thy upon the sheep. And said, which way went the spirit of the Lord from me? To speak unto thee, and with Kiah said, behold, thou shalt see on that day when thou shalt go into an inner chamber to hide thyself, and the king of Israel, O said, take ye with Kiah and her. Read him that to Amon the butler, learn the safety, and to Joash the king's son, and say, to say it to him, put his fellow in the prison, and feed him with bread of affliction, and with water of affliction, until I return in peace. And lift thy eyes, and if thou set on me written in peace, and hath not the Lord spoken by me? And he said, hearken, O ye sons of the king of Israel, and the Judah went up to Ramoth-Gilead, and the king of Israel said unto Jehoshaphat, I will despise myself, and will go to the battle, but put thou on thy robes, O the king of Israel, despised himself, and they went to the battle. Now the king of Syria had commanded the captains of the chariots that were with him, saying, fight ye not with small or great, save only with the king of Israel. And it came to pass when the captains of the chariots saw Jehoshaphat, that they said, it is the king of Israel, therefore Satan does come out here to fight, but Jehoshaphat cried out, and the Lord helped him, and God moved then to depart from him, for it came to pass that when the captains of the chariots perceived that it was not the hill of Israel, Satan led the men from the Zuilchin and the Satan and drew a bow at an answer and smote the hill of Israel between the joints of the harness. Therefore he said to his chariot, let the time end, that thou mayest carry me out of the host, for I am wounded, and the battle in priest that may hold it, the hill of Israel's cage himself, up in his chariot, against the Syrians, until the evening, and about the time of the sun going down, he hides him in Second Chronicles chapter 19, and Jehoshaphat the king of Judah returned to his house in the east to Jerusalem, and Ishu the son of Hanani the seer went out to meet him and said to him, Jehoshaphat, what dost thou help the ungodly and love them that hate the Lord? Therefore is wrath upon thee from before the Lord. Nevertheless, there are no sins found in thee, in that thou hast taken away the gross out of the land, and hast prepared thine heart to seek God. And Jehoshaphat dwelt at Jerusalem, and he went out of and through the people from Beersheba to Mount Ephraim, and brought them back unto the Lord God of their fathers, and he set judges in the land throughout all the fenced cities of Judah. Sit he and said to the judges, take heed what ye do, for ye judge not for men, but for the Lord, who is with you in the judgment. Wherefore now let the fear of the Lord be upon you, take heed and do it, for there is no iniquity with the Lord our God, nor is respect of persons, nor take him as gifts, nor of her in Jerusalem. Did Jehovah affect it unto the Levites and unto priests, and unto the chief of the fathers of Israel, for the judgment of the Lord, and for controversies with a return to Jerusalem, and he pardoned them, saying, "Thus shall ye do in the fear of the Lord faithfully and with a perfect heart, and work whatsoever shall come to you of your brethren that dwell in their cities, between blood and blood, between war and commandment, statutes and judgments, ye shall be in all tents, that faith resteth not against the Lord, and so rest upon you and upon your brethren, his due, and ye shall not trespass, and behold them arise at the chief priest is over you in all matters of the Lord, and there may be a dozen of it may enter ruined the house and do the for all the his matters also the Levites shall be officers before you, be courageous, we and the Lord shall be with the Lord's in this section from Chronicles chapter 20. It came to pass after his also had the children of Moab and the children of Ammon, and with them a beside the Ammonites came against Jehoshaphat, who met them, and their chains unset, told Jehoshaphat, saying, "There cometh a great mountain to the beyond the sea of his side.
Seer, whom thou of dust not let his
Israel in chains, when they came out of the land of Egypt, but they turned from them and destroyed them. But behold, Isaiah, how they reward us to come to cast us out of sight, a nation which thou hast beloved us to inherit, O our God, wilt thou not judge them? For we have no might against his great company, that commit against us the eternal wheel. What to do but our eyes are above the end, all to us told before the Lord, which their wisdom loves, their wives and their children, head upon the Aegean, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jehoiakim, the son of Mattaniah. We light on the sons of Azeth, came the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the tundra nation, and he said, hearken ye all to God, and ye in heaven, the tongues of Jerusalem, and shout in the hush of it, say it, the Lord unto you, be not afraid, Lord is made by reason of his great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's to for the wind blew us unto ruin. Ye cannot need to fight in his net. Tongues at your hands stand ye still, and see the damnation of the Lord with you. Fear not, Lord. and Jehovah. Set bowed his head with kiss, face to the ground and all to the end, inhabitant of Jerusalem, stand before the Lord with us. Did the Lord and the Levites ask us, and bring us the Jehoshaphat and us the children of God, for heights to the two grace, the Lord God of Israel, and with a loud voice on high, and say, Rosa, we in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa, and as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, Hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God, so can ye be established with me. Leave his rough upsell. Can ye prosper? And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed elders unto the Lord, and set forth grace the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army, and to say, Praise the Lord for his mercy, and your is forever. And when they began to sing and to praise the Lord, set the movements against the children of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. For the children of Ammon and Moab stood up against thee, and had the tops of Mount Seir utterly to slay and destroy them, and when they had made an end of me, it had the tops of Seir and everyone tempt to much power examined the same time to the mountain. And then some say were then of these some unto the earth, and none escaped. And when Jehoshaphat and his people came to take away the spoilers, then they found among them in abundance both riches with God, and of these, and precious jewels which they stripped off. For themselves more had they to carry away, and they were 3 days in that ruin of the spoil. It was so much, and on the fourth day they assembled themselves in the valley of the Rasha, for there they blessed the Lord there. For the name of the same place was called the valley of the Rasha to this day. And they returned every man of Judah and Jerusalem and Jehoshaphat in the forefront of them, again to Jerusalem with joy, for the Lord had made them to rejoice over their enemies. And they came to Jerusalem with psalteries and harps and trumpets unto the house of the Lord, and the fear of God was on all the kingdoms of those countries when they had heard that the Lord fought against the enemies of Israel. So the remnant of Jehoshaphat was twice the forces of nations raised round the mountain. Jehoshaphat reigned over Judah. He was 35 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 25 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Azuba, the daughter of Shim. He and he walked in the way of Asa, his father, and departed not from it, to in that which was right in the sight of the Lord. How may it the high places were not taken away, for as yet the people had not prepared their hearts unto the God of their fathers. Now the rest of the acts of Jehoshaphat, first and last, behold, they are written in the book of Vishnu, the son of Hanani, who is mentioned in the book of the kings of Israel. And after this did Jehoshaphat king of Judah joined himself with Ahaziah king of Israel, unto them very wickedly, and he joined himself with him to make ships to go to Tarshish and they made the ships in Ezion be
to the end may
Prince Elsa, his hand her arm went for wit, his bread sauce and polish, his cherry up, switch him and he rolls up by light and smoke. Feed the mice with the past chin in and look at Tom's on top. Cherry up, so feed the mice revolted from a and the two his days the same time also did with the result from under his hand because he had forsaken the Lord the Bash his father's moreover he high places in the mountains unto the end of the inhead, the tops of Jerusalem to come it for it ate the mountains unto the there too, and there came a writing to him from Elijah the prophet saying, thus saith the Lord God of David, thy father because thou hast not obtained the ways of Jehovah the prophet thy father nor in the ways of Asa in the Judah but hast walked in the way of the kings of Israel and hast made Jerusalem to go a horrid light to the whoredoms of the house of Ahab and also has slain thy brethren of father's house which were necked and thy sent me hope with a great blade with the Lord's might thy kingdom and thy kindred and thy wives and all thy books and thou shalt have great sickness by disease of thy bowels until thy bowels fall out by reason of the sickness by day moreover the Lord's turn up against her on the spirit of the Philistines and of the Arabians to the end break it. David's house and his sons also, and his wife so fat. There was then a son left in Zanjah, his sons and after all his towers much in inches thou arms with an impure above disease, and it came to pass that in process his bowels fell out by reason of his sickness. So he died of sore diseases, and his deed made the burden for him.
Cheers.